Hello and greetings from Iceland. This is just a little extra video since the earthquake action is going off the charts or just when I was about to finish a new video covering the big picture. So I will have to change that script and I will do it again tomorrow. But in the meantime, I'm going to tell you briefly how the evening has turned out. It started with a magnitude 4 earthquake in Bárðarbunga volcano under Vatnajökull glacier. Followed with a 3.8, no aftershocks there, so that's nothing to worry about. But oddly enough, the volcano Katla started to shake shortly thereafter, first with earthquakes slightly under magnitude 3, and I think that Katla was also hit with an earthquake larger than 4, but it's just so much going on that the meteorological office is very busy tonight, overviewing all the data that's coming in. And it does happen that we see two systems be shaking simultaneously. So I kept my cool until the Reykjanes Peninsula started. And this story that I was trying to finish about the Reykjanes Peninsula was mentioning this volcanologist that was just telling us that we should get ready for the usual thing, like last year and the year before, or to get ready for some earthquakes before the eruption comes up, because there is a magma intrusion and the epicentre is under Mount Fagradalsfjall like last year, but there is however one huge difference between what was going on back then and now. And that is that the land uplift that has been confirmed is not just under Mount Fagradalsfjall, but all over the peninsula, indicating perhaps a way larger event than we got last year and in 2021. And this script that I was making today, I was actually speculating there if we should have to wait for some months. Experts say that the magma is at 15 kilometers depth, so that means that we will have to wait for some time. And looking at this tonight, everything going full force, the earthquakes are now at 5 to 6 kilometers depth. It would not surprise me if we would get an eruption there before the summer is over. And I also think that the earthquakes that we see now, it's going to get worse before it gets better. When they are magnitude 3 plus, they can be felt in Reykjavík. And people were getting very tired of this last year. Earthquakes more and less all day, for days. Then it would get better for a while, and worse again. But the big thing is that this is the biggest earthquake swarm since before the eruption in 2022. And I'm very sure that we will get some LiDAR or INSAR images very soon. But as for the question, where will the next eruption take place? It looks to me now that we are again looking at Mount Fagradalsfjall. And that is actually good news if we are looking at the so-called tourist eruption type. However, according to those information about land uplift, there is something very strange going on there. So don't expect an eruption tonight, but we can expect way more earthquakes and larger. And tomorrow morning, I'm going to go over all the data that we have after the night and add them into the script that I was doing today, where I will also be talking about how I'm going to cover this event here on my channel, because I have some new tools that will be put into good use. But more about that tomorrow, and I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.